Welcome students to session number 28, that is the revision session of chapter number 3, motion in a straight line. Today we are going to revise the topic, that is average speed and instantaneous speed. Now what is average speed first? Average speed we are going to revise, and one more topic that is we are going to revise, that is instantaneous speed. That is instantaneous speed. Now let's move on. What is average and instantaneous? Before moving to average and instantaneous speed, better let us clear the term first, that is speed. What is speed? The time rate of change of position. The time rate of change of position of an object in any direction. In any direction. Is called speed of an object. Is called speed of an object. Here the word very important is in any direction. In any direction and time rate of change of position. Now in any direction means speed is equal to total distance traveled. Total distance traveled divided by total time taken. Till this clear? Also, in any direction means speed is a scalar quantity. Speed is a scalar quantity. Has only magnitude. But no specific direction. So it is scalar quantity. Is this clear? Now we know that SI unit. What is SI unit? Meter. Distance is meter and time is in second. CGS unit is somebody asked. What is CGS unit? Centimeter per second. Yes or no? CGS unit is centimeter per second. And somebody asked the dimensional formula. So dimensional formula we do have, that is m0 l1 t minus 1. Okay, this is clear. What is exactly speed? What is, whether it is scalar or vector, dimensional formula, units. The next topic we do have, that is types of speed. The very first in this topic we are going to study, that is uniform speed. Now what exactly uniform speed means? Can anybody tell me what is exactly uniform speed? Uniform word itself indicates that an object, I am clearing first, uniform means equal distances in equal intervals of time. In this clear? An object is said to be moving with uniform speed. If it covers equal distances in equal intervals of time. Clear? Here important term, that is equal distances and equal intervals of time. The next two we have, that is variable speed. The variable stands for what? Changing. So unequal distances in equal intervals of time. You remember two things. This is equal, here it is unequal. Equal intervals of time. Here I can write that an object is said to be moving with moving with variable speed, if it covers unequal distances in equal intervals of time. However, these time intervals may be clear. Here important word is unequal distances in equal intervals of time. Moving ahead to the third category we do have with us, that is average speed. Now basically average means what? If it is variable speed, if object is moving with variable speed, then only the term comes what? Average speed. Then total distance upon total time taken. Total distance covered in total time taken. Clear? So I can say that average speed, if the object is moving with variable speed, means its speed is changing every now and then it is its variable speed. If the object is moving with variable speed, then the average speed of the object is equal to the ratio of total distance covered by total time taken. Clear? So average speed you can determine by equation average speed, that is equal to total distance traversed divided by total time taken. Till this clear? The last category we do have into the speed is instantaneous speed. That is instantaneous speed. Instantaneous, the word itself indicates a particular instant of time. Clear? This type of speed is indicated by instantaneous speed is indicated by speedometer of vehicle. When you are moving on vehicle, you will be able to see that the speed indicator gives you what? Instantaneous speed. Is this clear? Now what is instantaneous speed? The speed of an object at particular instant of time or speed at particular point of its path is called instantaneous speed. Will this clear? Now if object covers small distance, we can say delta x. Small distance I'm representing by delta x in small time interval, that is delta t. I'm considering small time interval delta t. Therefore average speed is total distance upon total time taken at that instant of time t. Will this clear? Now if this delta t approaches to zero, then this will be converted into instantaneous speed. So I can write over here, if the time interval delta t approaches to zero, the limiting value of average speed is nothing but instantaneous speed of the object. Is this clear? I can write one thing over here. Instantaneous speed that is equal to limit time interval approaches to zero. What is limiting value of average speed? That is going to this delta will be converted into d. So dx by dt. This dx by dt is nothing but first order derivative of x means what? A distance. First order derivative of distance with respect to time. Hope it is clear. This is nothing but your instantaneous speed. Clear? So your instantaneous speed that is equal to dx by dt. Hope till this is perfectly clear. Fine. Now we are going to see a few examples related to this that is given in the assignment. The very first example. If the object covers, I am not writing the data, I am directly writing the solution. If the object covers first half distance means we can consider to be d, with speed of 60 km per hour, and rest half of the distance, means again it is c only, because first half is your AC and second half is your BC. First half distance is AC, second half distance is BC, both are same. AC is equal to BC, both are same. Fine. And 60 km and this is 50 km per hour. They are asking find the average speed in the journey. Find the average speed of the journey. Now if somebody asks you find the average speed of the journey, and remember the distance traversed are equal, so you can say that here distance traversed are equal. If distance traversed are equal, then you can have that average speed. We do have formula for that. It is applicable to only two cases, because this is shortcut formula, JEE NEET. Shortcut. That is average speed that is equal to what? average speed that is equal to total distance, that is we do have formula 2 times V1 V2 divided by V1 plus V2. V1 we have 60, second we have 50 divided by 60 plus 50. Yes or no? 6 to the 12, 12 5 is how much? 60. So you can able to check 2 into 60 into 50. We are having with you that is 6000. And this is 60 plus 50. 60 plus 50 that is 110. Fine or not? So 00 cancel. 600 by 11. If we divide 600 by 11, we are going to get answer 54.54. 54.54 that is approx. This is more than 50. Your answer is 55 unit will be kilometer per hour. That is the first numerical. Till this clear? Next example we do have, that is if an object is moving on a circular path. An object is moving on a circular path. Now remember one thing. The object starts its journey from A, then it goes to B, then it goes to C, then it goes to D, and then it comes back to A. A, B, C to D, B to A. And it is moving on a circular path of radius R. So this is R, this is R, this is R, and this is R. Is this clear? Okay. We need to calculate distance and displacement for the following cases. Calculate distance and displacement for the following. First they are asking from A to B, then second they are asking B to C, third they are asking C to D. First A to B, then we'll write then. First they are asking from A to B, then second they are asking from A to B to C, then A to B to C to D, and last fourth A to B to C to D to and again back to A. These are the four types of the journey they have given, and we need to calculate the total distance and total displacement. First, A to B we can take. For A to B, this much only. So distance I can say 1/4 part. Yes or no? This is part 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1/4 part. This is 1/4 part. Clear? Of how much? 2 pi r. 2 pi r is total circumference of the circle. I'm going to get by 2. My answer is what? Pi r by 2? Yes or no? Pi r by 2 or not? Fine. Pi r by 2 units. That is my distance for the first case, A to B. Now we need to find displacement. So displacement is nothing but shortest distance between A and B. Means this much, yes or no? Shortest distance between A and B. So I can write that second point over here, that I need to calculate displacement. So displacement, that is nothing but what? Magnitude of AB. That is right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle. So this is R, this is R. So I can calculate this. That is R square plus R square. So I am going to get 2 R square. So my answer is root 2 R. My answer is root 2 R. Is this clear? Second we do have with us, that is A to B to C. A to B to C, I have distance. Distance that is equal to A to B to C. Distance is this much. That is 2 parts. So it is half of 2 pi R. Yes or no? Half semicircle means half of 2 pi R. So my answer is how much? Pi R units. Here, and this is root 2 R units. So displacement I can write. Displacement that is equal to what? Magnitude of shortest distance between the start and is this. That is magnitude of AC. That is nothing but R plus R. My answer is how much? 2 R units. Till this clear? Third I do have with me is A to B to C to D. Third I do have with me is A to B to C to D. Clear? Again distance. Check first part, second part, third part. So I can say 3 by 4 of 2 pi r. Yes or not? 2. So my answer is 3 by 2 pi r units. And if somebody asks me displacement. And displacement that is equal to shortest distance between start and final. Start is A, final is D. So this is R, this is R. So I can get by this Pythagoras this much. So displacement is nothing but AD.
displacement is nothing but AD, that is equal to under root of R square plus R square, that is under root 2 R square, that is root 2 R units. Till this clear? I do have the fourth category with me, that is A2, B2, C2, D2, A. Fourth category I do have, that is A2, B2, C2, B2, A. Now this is start, here initial point and final point are same. Here initial position, that is equal to final position. Here initial position, that is equal to final position. If initial and final position are same, then displacement is 0. We already knew that. Therefore displacement is 0. Here 0 units. And distance, that is nothing but what? Total circumference, that is nothing but what? 2 pi r units. Hope this sum is perfectly clear.
Fine. Here we do have a question in which the object is traveling from O to P first case and second O to P to Q in second case. Is this clear? Now first we have to find out average speed and average velocity in following cases. Average speed and average velocity in following cases. Clear? The first case we do have the journey from O to P and second we have journey O to P to back to Q like this. So first I am going to calculate for O to P. O to P journey I am calculating. First I am calculating distance. Distance that is equal to O to P. 360 minus 0. 360 minus 0. So answer is plus 360 meters. And if I want to calculate displacement. So displacement that is equal to final position minus initial. Final is P. Initial is 0. So P minus 0. That is 360 minus 0. So my answer is plus 360 meters. Till this clear? Now average speed. We do have equation that is average speed. Average speed that is equal to what? Path length divided by time taken. Path length divided by time taken. What is path length? Tell me. Path length is distance. Distance is how much? 360 meters. Divided by time taken. 18 minus 0. 18 minus 0. So the answer is 360 by 18. So 18 20s are 360. The answer is 20 meter per second. Will this clear? If somebody asks me your average velocity, so average velocity that is equal to what? Displacement upon time, displacement upon total time taken, yes or no? So displacement upon total time taken, what is displacement over here? That is 360 meters, time taken is again 18 seconds, my answer is how much? 20 meter per second. Here you will be able to notice that if an object is moving on a straight line, then its average speed and average velocity are same. Average speed and average velocity are same. In the same direction. From O to P is only one direction. So you will get average speed and average velocity to be same. Is this clear?
Hope it is cleared.
The next case which you have, that is O to P to back to Q. So first I will calculate distance. So distance that is equal to what? O to P first. O to P already I know that is 360 meters plus P to Q. P to Q means 360 minus 240. 360 minus 240 over here. This is 360. Is this clear? This is 60 and 60, that is 120. That is nothing but how much? 480 meters. Will this clear? Will this is clear? 100%? Fine. Now if I want to calculate displacement, displacement that is equal to final position minus initial, final is Q and initial is O. So Q minus 0, that is 240 minus 0. 240 minus 0, so answer is how much? 240 meters. So if somebody asks me average speed, and average speed that is equal to what? Distance upon time. What is distance O to P? Or distance I have 480 meters and time, remember time, first from O to P that is 18 seconds and again from P to Q I do have 6 seconds more. 18 minus 12 is what? 6. So 18 plus 6 I do have, that is how much? 24. Yes or no? So I do have answer is how much? 20 meter per second. And if somebody asks me average velocity, then average velocity that is equal to displacement upon time. Displacement upon time. What is displacement we have with us? That is 240 meters. And time taken. Time taken how much? 24 seconds. So my answer is how much? 10 meter per second.
Till this clear perfectly. We'll see more topics in the next session. Thank you so much.